When I'd gone into Baghdad just at the beginning of 1991, just a few days before the air war was due to begin, I'd carried in a huge satellite telephone. And when I look back at the pictures of it now, this is a huge metal case, and it's got a big umbrella antenna on it. But I had to smuggle it into the country. And we kind of wrote things on it like this was some kind of video device converter. And I remember going through the customs with the customs officials, and they're like taking this out, this huge case. Mr. Robertson, what's this? Oh, it's a standards converter. Mr. Robertson, this silver umbrella in your suitcase? Oh, yeah, that's just an umbrella. They didn't ask, why has your umbrella got so many holes in it? So we got that into the country, but inevitably, maybe 3 or 4 days into the war, even the communications tower that the four wire went through was targeted and hit by coalition bombing. And that was the moment where we had to say to the Iraqis, well, oh gee, guess what we found lying around the office? Our satellite telephone. And by then, all the other journalists had long been sent out of the country, and it was only CNN who was there. And Peter Arnett was able to use his satellite telephone to bring the story to the audience.
If you're still with us, you're going to hear the bombs now. They are hitting the center of this city.
That first Gulf War was, for me, an incredible experience. I mean, real heavy bombing. In fact, one time in the Rashid Hotel, a cruise missile came down very close, about 200 yards from the hotel, and it blew in the windows, and we were thrown across the room. I remember when the bombs first started dropping, I was one of the first people into the bomb shelter, and realized I got down so quickly, no one else was there, so I had to go back upstairs to see what was going on. But a very, very interesting period, and a great storytelling time for CNN.